Good morning, student. As you all had doubt regarding chapter 4 of how to draw the graph, so as you can see, I am taking here three examples, and I hope that by looking at these three examples, you all will be cleared with the doubts that you are having. So in the first equation, you can see here with your x variable 4 is related, with your y variable 3 is related, and on the right hand side you can see it's a constant function. So suppose now you have to draw the graph of this equation. Okay, so how you shall do, let us see here. Okay, so what you have to draw is, you take a box. Okay, so your main equation is 4x plus 3y equals to 12. Okay, that means what x value and what y value you will take should be equal to your 12. Okay, suppose now, for the simple easy way of how to take the values, simply if you take x value as 0, so if your x value is 0, so this part will be eliminated, so your y value will be how much? 4. And suppose if you take y value as 0, so this part will be eliminated, your x value will be equal to what? 3. Okay? And you can take some more example. For example, suppose 4x you can keep here, 12 minus 3y, that means x value will be equal to 12 minus 3y by 4. That means what y value you are going to put, that must be divisible by your 4. Suppose if I take y value as 1, so 12 minus 3 is what? 9. So 9 cannot be divided by 4, isn't it? If I take 2, so 12 minus 6 is what? 6. 6 divided by 4 is what? 6 divided by 4 is not divisible by 4. But if I take y equal to 0, we are getting what? X value is coming to be 3. So what value you can take so that it must be divisible by 4. Okay, so in this way you can take either two solution, or you can take more than two solution, that is your choice. Okay, you cannot, don't be confused with this. So suppose let me take this two as your solution. Okay, so what I will draw is the graph. You can take two points, your choice, x, 0, x dash, y, y dash. So 1, 2, since there are no negative numbers, so simply you can do like this, 1, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1. So all this you have to draw in a graph, then you will get the exact value. So 0, 4 will be this point, and next is your 3, 0. So 3, 0 will be this. And when you join this, you can see you have to write this as this, 4x plus 3y equals to 12. So you can see it's a straight line. So straight line means this is known as your linear equation. Okay, so since it is giving us a straight line, after joining the points you are getting a linear equation. Okay, next, let us go for the equation number 2, that is 2x plus 5y equals to 0. Simple, always you have to take easy. You take either when your x will be 0, when your x is 0, so when you put your x value as 0, so y will be 0. Simple. Next, suppose if I put x value as 1, so how much you will get your y value? So here it will get 2, so you will have 2 plus 5y equals to 0, that means 5y equals to minus 2, that means y value will be coming as how much? Minus 2 by 5. So minus 2 by 5, you can put it like this. Okay, suppose if I take x value as minus 2, so you will get here how much? Minus 2 plus 5y equals to 0, that means 5y equals to 2. So y will be equals to 2 by 5. So when your x value is negative, you are getting your y value to be how much? 2 by 5. Isn't it? So here you can see your coordinates is 0, 0, 1, minus 2 by 5. minus 1, 2 by 5. Now suppose this is very minimum to plot in the graph, isn't it? So as you can see, it is very difficult to plot this type of fraction, isn't it? So always you take, if you want to show some solution, so suppose your question may be like this. So whenever this type of points are there, it is difficult. So you can write what are the solution for this answer. It can be this, it can be this, it can be this. So these are some of the solutions for this equation. It can be infinite number of solution. Okay, you will have different. If you take x value as 3, you will have your y value as minus 6 by 5. If you take x value as minus 3, you will have y value 6 by 5. So you are having many solution for any equation of graph. Okay, number 3 is 3y plus 4 equals to 0. So here, since there is no any other variable, only one variable is there, isn't it? So simply you write it like this. Write y equals to minus 4 by 3. And this type of solution is one solution. So you have to plot it by showing as only one axis, because there is no x-axis value. Simply there is only y value. Okay, minus 4 by 3, you will have approximately, it will come in minus negative side of 1 point something, isn't it? So you can here also, so what will be the solution? So you can write here, since how you are getting y value minus 4 by 3, because there is 0. Okay, and suppose one more solution you want. So what you can do is, if you put y value as 1, your x value, if you put your y value as 1, your x value will be minus 4 by 3, isn't it? So you can write this type of solution. Okay, so these are some solutions you can create by yourself by looking at the equations. Okay, so here there are many ways of finding of how to draw the graph. Okay, so I shall be taking one more example. Suppose I am taking x plus 2y equals 6. Now you are asked to find to draw a graph. So how you will draw the graph? So what I am taking is, suppose now this time I will take 4 solution. Okay, I want 4 solution. So simple, put your x value as 0. So if your x value is 0, so y value will be coming as 3. When your y value is 0, your x value will be coming as 6. Okay. Suppose now I want to take x value as 2. So if I take x value as 2, so 2 plus 2y equals 6. So 2y will be equal to 4. So y will be coming as 2. Okay. Now suppose if I take x value as minus 2, that will be your 8. Y value will be coming to be, if I put x value as minus 2, y value will be coming as 4. Okay, so how it is coming, you see here. How I am getting this type of answer. So x equal to 6 minus 2y. Simply you can do like this. If your y value is 0, so x value is coming to be 6. Okay. Next, if your y value is 2, 6 minus 2 is what? 4, 2 into 2 is 4, it is coming 2. Next, if your y value is 4, 6 minus 8 is how much? Minus 2. So like this, using equation, one variable, you put it on the right hand side and you can find the other variable. Okay. Now suppose I want to draw the graph for this equation. So what are my solution now? 0, 3, 6, 0, 2, 2, and minus 2, 4. So you have to draw it very carefully. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. So first point is 0, 3. 0 means x is 0, y will be 3. This is your first point. Okay. Next is 6, 0. X is 6, y is 0. So this is, okay. Next is 2, 2. So it will come here. Next is minus 2, 4. So minus 2, 4 is here. Okay. And whenever you see, if you join all this point, you will get a straight line. So this may not be perfect as I am not drawing in the graph. But when you draw the graph and you join the solution of this any equation, you will always get a straight line. Okay, so this type of equation is known as linear equation in two variables. Okay, there are two variables that you can say x and y. Suppose if there is this one, this is known as either this or either this will be known as linear equation of one variable. So I hope that now all of you will be cleared in solving any linear equation by taking any points on the graph. Okay, so all of you now try to practice and do the exercise sums.